imagine that there's an art gallery opening up in a couple of months, and they're looking for pieces from local artists to display in their gallery. But they don't want any fakes coming into the gallery, so they hire a detective to figure out which paintings are real and which paintings are fake. Now, in the neighborhood, we have this forger who's kind of new to the forgery game and only looking to make a quick buck off of selling some fakes to the museum. But so he starts making a bunch of forgeries, but he's not very good at it, so the detective that they hired to catch the fakes has a really easy time figuring out that his paintings are fake. So over the next couple of months, the forger keeps on practicing. He keeps on iterating on his past versions of his paintings, trying to copy what looks real from real paintings and figure out what features he can implement in his fakes to make them more real. And his objective is to fool the detective. Now, the detective also gets better because he has more practice examining which paintings are real and fake, but at a certain point, he just can't figure out which ones are real and which ones are fake. So by the time the gallery actually opens, half the paintings in the museum are real and half the paintings in the gallery are fake. So what I've really laid out here is the basic structure of how a GAN works. This is a special type of neural network that actually stands for a generative adversarial network, which is actually two neural networks that are competing against each other. So the first neural network is a generator, which takes in a random input vector of random numbers and takes that noise and generates it into samples or images. Those images, along with real training data, as in real images, are fed into the discriminator, which the discriminator's job is to figure out which paintings are real or fake. So how this would look in practice is the discriminator would get a real painting like this, Vincent van Gogh's Starry Night, and then it would get a fake painting like this, which would be from Google's Deep Dream AI, and it would its job would be to find the differences between each painting, what features make a painting real and what features make a painting fake. And it would denote which one's real with a 1 and which one's fake with a 0. Now, here's what it actually looks like in code. You can see that each of the three lines that are in sections separated by comments are actually a type of layer. The type of variant of a GAN that I built is called a DC GAN, or a deep convolutional GAN. And each layer is making transformations to the image that basically just takes the key features of the image and transfers it onto the next layer until we actually have a full represented 64 by 64 pixel image in color that has the full representation of the features. Now, this is a more visual intuition of how this actually works, where it's taking blocks of key features after scanning it with a filter and taking the most important features from each group of pixels and passing it on to the next layer. And the most important parts of the image is passed on into the last layer, that 64 by 64 colored image. So this is what it actually looks like when I train the GAN. So on the left, you can see the real celebrities that I used to feed into the discriminator, along with generated images that came from the generator. And after just training for one time period, I had this result. It's not really quite good enough to fool any real humans, and they don't look like real faces, but you can clearly see the intention that the generator had behind generating these faces. The outline of all the facial features are there, the face, the nose, the eyes. We can clearly see that. And after iterating multiple times, we can actually get really realistic looking celebrities. Like, if I saw one of these on the street, I would think that was a real famous person. This has a really, really scary implication, because it can turn a smart president who's really good looking and handsome into an ugly orange man. Now, this is actually a special type of GAN that generates these images called deepfakes, which is really, really scary, because I could take an image of myself saying anything and put Donald Trump's face over it, and basically anything that I say is what Donald Trump is saying. And it's getting harder and harder to spot deepfakes from actually real images. Now, on a lighter note, what if I wanted to draw something like a cat, but I'm not really that great of an artist? I could just draw the outline and have the pix-to-pix process convert into fully-fledged cat with fur and eyes and ears and everything. This is a type of conditional GAN. And say I wanted to change it up a little bit and actually make a cat in a hat. But this doesn't really work very well, as you can see. The hat is a little bit too furry for my taste, but that's because this network was only trained on images of a cat, so it can't really know how to draw a hat without us programming that in. It's not fully intelligent. But we can go even past images. We could actually have GANs create things like music. Think of it. In images, we're looking for features like shapes, curves, and edges. in music, we could just look for features like chords, harmonies, and melodies, and put that all together to get really realistic sounding computer-generated music. It's insane. So what GANs tend to do is blur the line between what's simulated and what's real. Now you might be thinking that, oh, nothing's real, I can't trust my eyes, everything's forged. But that's not really what you should take away from this. Machines are really just an extension of our own creativity, used to create and make what we physically can't ourselves. And as for consuming music and art, well, we know that everything's gonna change. AI is like electricity, it'll be everywhere. In 10 years, we might be listening to bands like Guns N' Roses, or songs like Gucci Gang. But for that, we'll just have to discriminate between what's real and what's computer generated, and figure out what we believe. Thank you.